morning and praise the Lord in Jesus' name. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Listen, I am reminded of Psalms chapter 122 and verse 1. It says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. This morning, I encourage you, I inspire you to get to the local place of worship, to get to a church and worship with those like believers. It's not about me inspiring you to come to this place of worship, but it's about inspiring you to go to a place of worship where God is glorified, where Jesus is magnified, his sacrifice is remembered, and people receive him as their Savior. I just want to give you 10 reasons this morning why you should go to church, and we'll just jump right in. Number one, to hear the preaching of God's word. Romans 10:17 says that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Number two, to participate in corporate worship. You need to be with a body of believers. Remember on the day of Pentecost, they all came together. They were all in one accord, and the power of the Holy Ghost came in their midst, and they all were filled with the Holy Spirit. When we're in unity and we're worshiping God, we're in expectation of seeing what God has for us. Number three, because iron sharpens iron. Proverbs 27:1 says, iron sharpens iron. We sharpen one another. We are able to lift one another up, encourage one another. That's one of the reasons that you should go to church this morning. Number four, to exercise your gift. You are a part of the body of Christ, so you have an intricate part to play. You may be a preacher. You may be a hospitality person. You may be a worship leader. You may be a part of the worship. You have a part to do in the body of Christ. Number five, to encourage your pastor. Listen, we love to see you come into the church. We're glad to be a part of the body of Christ and to help you in your walk with Jesus Christ. It gives my heart good to see people come through the door and knowing that they're coming to praise God. Number six, to find godly mentors. As you got this walk, as you move forward, there's people that you can bond with, that you can actually learn from, and people that can help you in this Christian walk that has done it for years and years and years, and the Lord will set you up with them. Number seven, to teach your kids to come to church, to love church. We live in a world that our children need to know the goodness of the Lord. And if we can bring them to church and tell them of the love of Jesus Christ, oh my goodness, they will grow up to be great, fine men and women. Number eight, to be the light of your community. When you come into the church, when you worship with the fellow believers, you can't help but shine. You can't help but go out with exuberant light that you have received from praise and worship. Number nine, to pray with one another. We have to come together. The Bible says, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am also in the midst. So we pray for one another. We pray and believe that God's going to answer our prayer. And we have another reason to come to church this morning. And then number 10, the Bible says, because God says so in Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 25. Here's what it says. Not forsaking the assembling of yourself together, as the manner of some is. Now watch the back clause of this scripture. It says, but exhorting one another as so much more as you see the day approaching. We know that we're getting closer to the revealing of Jesus Christ, to the rapturing of the church. It's time for us so much more to come and worship and be a part of the body of the Christ this Sunday morning. Get up, arise and shine, and come worship the Lord Jesus Christ together as a body of believers. Have a arise and shine day in Jesus' name. Amen.